We're installing the foil polystyrene system for battened floors. This product is great for ensuring the whole floor area is heated, even if the room is irregular in shape. It includes the floor insulation, which has pre-cut channels to hold the pipe, so your pipe spacing is already decided, and the pipe is protected from damage during installation. The main heating panels have foil already fitted that will help diffuse the heat. They also have a factory-fitted polyethylene film, which helps shield the channels from dirt and debris, and cuts out any ticking sounds. As well as the main panels, there are end return and channel panels to insulate the flow and return pipe connecting to the manifold. First, plan where these various panels are all going to go. Remember, some areas of the room may not have heating pipe, because underfloor heating shouldn't be installed under permanent fixtures, such as kitchen and bathroom fixings, for example. So for these parts of the floor area, you may need plain insulation panels. The pipe won't be going across or under these, of course, but they'll make sure the floor level and insulation are the same for the whole room space. Start by laying and fixing perimeter battens against the walls. The end return panels will be placed along the wall nearest the manifold location, as well as along the opposite wall. For the floor's heating areas, lay the first end return panel into a corner, then a main foil panel against the sidewall batten, and continue until the whole strip of floor is covered to another end return panel at the opposite end of the room. Then lay the next batten against the first row of polystyrene panels. If you need to cut foil panels to size, make sure you're wearing protective gloves. Not just for the cutting, but also while you're handling the panels, because the cut foil can be sharp. Measure and mark the length you need, then use a handsaw or circular saw to make the cut. If it's a handsaw you're using, we recommend you cut into the foil with the panel face up. If it's a power tool, then we suggest you cut with the panel facing down. Where there's cut foil across a pipe channel, you should ensure that no sharp edges are going to lie against the pipe, so use a blade to flange this edge to deburr it. Lay the next row of panels followed by the next batten, and so on until the whole floor area is covered, including any plain insulation panels where appropriate. With the foil panels, make sure that all the machine pipe channels match up with the channels in adjacent sections, or with the end return loops. It may be necessary to cut extra grooves in the panel, so that the pipe can connect to straights or channels near the manifold. You'll have to notch the battens wherever the pipe will need to cross them. This is usually only necessary at one end of the room. At the other end of the room, the pipe will just loop around in between the battens. Further notches will be needed to create a route for the flow and return pipework. It's your choice whether you route the notches with the panels in place, or mark the battens and lift out the panels while you're routing. Now you're ready to place the pipe into the pre-cut channels in the polystyrene insulation. Remove the wavin cutter from the pipe coil packaging and strip off the blue outer wrapping. Find the pipe end from the centre of the coil and feed out the pipe from here. When you start to install the pipe, make sure you leave a tail long enough to reach the proposed location of the manifold. Feed the pipe into the channels and press it down carefully and firmly into the pre-cut channels. You can do this using hands or feet. With this system, it's always a serpentine pattern up and down the room. Around the turns, it's often better to clip the pipe in place by hand, but on the long runs, it's quicker to unroll the pipe from a standing position and press it in by foot. Where the pipe tails are below the manifold location, clip the pipe into a curved pipe support to hold it securely in position. When all the pipe has been put in place, you can move on to the final installation stages, including pressure testing of the circuit, installation of the manifold, and pipe connections to it. Then comes wiring up of the controls and setting up of the thermostats. All these stages will be explained in our other installation videos. There are also guides to take you through installation of our other in-floor systems and through the installation of the foil polystyrene system in joisted or floating floors.